Hi, my name is Robin Wong, and I have here the Olympus Air, and I want to share my experience using it in this video. Let's do this. Before we start, shout out to Michael Copperthite. Michael, thank you so much for sending me your Olympus Air all the way from the US. In my previous videos, I've been mentioning on how curious I was on the Olympus Air, and now I finally have one in my hands. This is not going to be a review of this Olympus Air camera. I believe you want to find reviews, there are a lot available online. After all, this product was launched in 2015 by Olympus. However, I do want to talk about the concept of this modular camera system, how it is relevant today, and how it is the future for photography and cameras. I also want to explore the weaknesses of this Olympus Air, the first version done by Olympus, the shortcomings, and how Olympus could have done a few things a little bit better. And of course, if OM Digital Solutions were to make a version 2 in the future, hopefully they'll make the necessary improvements. I personally believe that the Olympus Air is ahead of its time. As a modular camera design, it is very simplistic and minimalist in nature. It doesn't have many dials and buttons. It doesn't even have an LCD screen or electronic viewfinder. Most of the controls are delegated to the smartphone. You need to pair this with your smartphone via Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and use a smartphone screen to compose your images and use the app to control all the camera settings, including autofocus. This means that stripping away all these features from this Olympus Air can truly make this really small, really light. This is in line with the philosophy of Micro Four Thirds system. However, having taken all that away, at the heart, the core of this Olympus Air, you still get the full-size Micro Four Thirds image sensor and a full metal mount for Micro Four Thirds lenses. You can mount any of the amazing Panasonic and Olympus lenses using it with the Olympus Air. This simply means, while you're using this with your smartphone, it is as if you're shooting with your smartphone, but at the same time, you're opening it up to a benefit of getting DSLR quality images, high resolution, better dynamic range, amazing low light performance. You can render shallow depth of field. You can have all these benefits of Micro Four Thirds while shooting with your smartphone. That was the core concept of this Olympus Air. I think the concept is amazing, but yes, implementation-wise, there are some flaws, which we will talk about a little bit later. The build quality of the Olympus Air is excellent. Though it's made of mostly plastic, it feels dense and solid in hand. The design is simplistic. The front of this Olympus Air is the lens mount. The top, there are two buttons, the shutter button and the power button. At the bottom of this Olympus Air, you have the tripod mount, which is made of metal. At the side, you have two releases. One is to release the lens mount, and the other one is to release the back accessory attachment, which is the clamp where you can attach the Olympus Air to your smartphone. The charging port as well as a micro SD card slot is also at the back. That's all you have on this Olympus Air. I like how simplistic it is, and I really love the minimalist and clean design of this Olympus Air. My experience shooting with the Olympus Air is a little bit hit and miss. To use the Olympus Air, you need to pair it with your smartphone using the OA Central app. OA means Olympus Air. OA Central is very similar to OI Share. iShare is an app where you use to connect your smart devices to your Olympus cameras. It connects with both Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Now, the interface, the controls, the connectivity steps, everything is very, very similar between these two apps, and even the shooting experience is very, very similar. When it works, when there are no problems, when the connection is stable, autofocus is fast, the controls were instantaneous, I can get my shots, everything is very, very smooth and efficient. There was simply no issue whatsoever. However, that's not the case most of the time. In every few minutes, I do run into connectivity issue. Maybe it's my smartphone or maybe it's my Wi-Fi connection that's not stable. It does stutter there and here. And when it stutters, the screen freezes. That's really annoying. And sometimes there are error messages or bugs that occurs and I do need to restart the connection. And basically the user experience is not very pleasant. There are honestly more misses than hits. I can't use this Olympus Air reliably for a long shooting duration. Within half an hour, I get disconnected maybe 4 to 5 times, and that's really frustrating. I'm not sure if that's the same experience with everyone else with the Olympus Air. If you do own an Olympus Air, please share your experience using it in the comments below. Let me know if you have the similar problems that I did. I would love to hear from you. So, what can Olympus do to improve the Olympus Air and make it a truly remarkable product? Number one, simplify the connection steps. To connect the Olympus Air to the smartphone, ideally, all you have to do is just press the power button and turn on the app on the smart devices. After that, everything should be automated. We don't have to do anything else. The connection should be established and ready to go. That would make the user experience so much better, so much simplified. And that's what we want. One touch, everything settled. Number two, improve connectivity. We want faster Wi-Fi and more reliable connection. No more drops, no more stutters, no more frozen screens, no more error messages. But I understand that back in 2015, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth technology back then is not really that fast compared to what we have today. We have 10 times faster Wi-Fi connection and maybe 5 times more bandwidth that the Bluetooth can carry. Implementing all this possibly can solve half of the problems that the Olympus Air had. Then we have to optimize the software, the programming, to really make the connectivity stable, reliable, and so much more pleasant to use. Number three, I really want Olympus to implement 5-axis image stabilization in the Olympus Air. If we have the powerful 5-axis image stabilization, the Olympus Air would have been a mini OMD. It is a stripped down version of the OMD, which you can use together with any of your smartphones. That is insane. It's amazing. You can take photographs of the Olympus Air with the capability of the Olympus OMD, with the advantage of the 5-axis image stabilization, and you get the images instantly into your smartphone after you press the shutter button. I would love that. And finally, number four, put a tiny LCD screen on the Olympus Air. It just has to be big enough for us to see how to frame the subject. It doesn't have to be big and clear with high resolution. It's just in case you need to get emergency shots. We don't have time to pair it with the smartphone. You see it, you power on the Olympus Air. With that tiny screen, you can quickly grab the shot. That would have created more shooting opportunities using the Olympus Air. Thank you. We all know that the camera sales are declining drastically year after year, and the camera industry is shrinking. Smartphone photography is taking over, whether you like it or not. The way I see it, the future of the camera business depends on how the camera industry can quickly evolve to adapt and coexist alongside smartphones. One feasible solution is to create a modern system that you can attach to any smartphone and use to take photographs. I think Olympus Air presents that opportunity, and I believe with a little bit of tweaks and improvement, this can be the future of photography. That's all I have to share about the Olympus Air. I hope you found it beneficial. Please consider buying me a cup of coffee, or you can contribute directly to my PayPal account. I'll put the links in the description below on how I can do that. Any small contribution can go a long way and help me to continue making similar content and publish them right here. If you've enjoyed watching this video and looking at my photographs, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing, and I'll definitely see you again in the next one. Until then, please go out and take more photographs. Bye-bye.